official proposal, official bids, or anything like this. But it's also important to say that Barcelona have... Hey guys, welcome back on the channel. Fabrizio Romano here, as always, to keep you posted on the transfer market. And today, guys, we touch on Lamine Yamal, one more for Barcelona to discuss another top talent, and Toni Kroos future. Let's jump into it together. And so, guys, important to mention today the interview of Barcelona president Laporta, who mentioned that Barça said no to a proposal worth 200 million euros for Lamine Yamal. What's the point? Sources guaranteed that the club prepared to approach Barcelona for Lamine Yamal is Paris Saint-Germain, that there is an interest from Paris Saint-Germain. At the moment, we don't have confirmation on an official proposal, on a formal proposal, but we know how it works in the transfer market world. It's about asking information, trying to approach clubs, using agents as part of this, and the president of Barcelona, Laporta, guarantees that Barcelona is prepared to say no to 200 million euros for Lamine Yamal. Why? First of all, because Barça believe that Lamine has to be the face of this project and for the future. So no intention to sell the player at this stage. And also important to say that Barcelona, I already told you months ago, believed that the new contract of Lamine Yamal next year, in 2025, when he will turn 18, is going to be almost guaranteed thanks to the relationship they have with the players' camp, and also because they believe Lamine will have a really important proposal from Barça, and so he will be the face of this project. So Barcelona are preparing their future around Lamine Yamal and other players too, of course, but Lamine is one of them, and this is why they are prepared to reject proposals for him. But the club behind the scenes interested is Paris Saint-Germain, even if we don't have confirmation on official proposal, official bids, or anything like this. But it's also important to say that Barcelona have one more gem. We know they're producing a lot in their academy, and the player who is only playing for the academy at the moment, but already called up by Xavi with the first team, still waiting to make his debut, is Mikael Fayet. This centre-back signed from the second division in Croatia, from Custosia. This is the name of the club. It was an exclusive news, I told you, last summer. It was at the end of May, beginning of June, when Barcelona agreed the deal for Mikael Fayet, this defender born in Senegal. Well, for Barcelona, still waiting to make him debut. So let's see when Mikael Fayet will have this possibility. But meanwhile, this boy is doing fantastic in the academy. And already three clubs wanted him last January. Lens made a proposal, 9 million euros, a really important one. And Barcelona said no. There was interest also from Ajax and Girona. These two clubs wanted Fayet, but Barcelona didn't want to negotiate. Now, Fayet made his debut with Senegal national team and also scored a fantastic goal with his left foot. So this is a special talent. Barcelona know that. They believe that he's going to be the next one to enter into the first team. But it's also important to say that Barça will have to make a decision now for the summer. Keep Fayet, trust him, include him in the first squad, or make profit with Fayet by selling him with many clubs interested around Europe. For sure, an interesting situation for an interesting talent. And also, guys, important to mention Toni Kroos. I will keep you posted on his future in the next weeks. Meanwhile, Toni Kroos is back with the German national team, but I keep going on my way. What I told you 1 month ago about Toni Kroos and Real Madrid is that there is optimism and confidence to keep Toni Kroos at the club at least for one more season. So Real Madrid remain optimistic, Real Madrid remain confident, they are waiting for Toni to make his final decision on the future, but the optimism at the club is there. They believe there is a good chance to keep Toni Kroos at the club. And so, guys, let me know your thoughts on Toni Kroos, Mikael Fayet, and obviously Lamine Yamal. How much is Lamine Yamal worth in your opinion? I wait for your comments, guys. Here as always, remember to like this video, turn on the notification bell, subscribe to the channel. See you soon with Fabrizio. Ciao.